If you kill him, they'll never stop looking.
Grant unto him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him.
He's going to spend the rest of his life looking over his shoulder until someone catches up with him.
It's an eel.
I'm going to get him, John. I promise you.
Things, they're ruining pub life.
Come on! Let's go! Just go in there! Don't move! Let's go!
Evening, guys. Keeping the finger on the pulse, eh?
G'day, mate. Something we can do for you?
Oh, I'm sorry. Look, I'm Derek Conway. I'm over here on holiday. I'm in the Met, CID.
Ah. Derek, London, eh? Uh-huh. Where's your snorkel and flippers, mate?
Tell me about it.
Hey, look out for that yellow thing in the sky. It's called the sun.
Right. Look, I just left the wife in the hotel. She's crashed out, jet lag, and thought I'd check out the hotspots. Any chance of a steer, you know?
What, for a fellow cop, right? Yeah, jump aboard. We'll give you the full guided tour.
Great.
Hop in.
Tough beating out here, yeah?
Usual pack of mongrels, pimps, dopers, standover men.
Standover?
Hey,
extortion. Plus, anything you want to buy or sell, legal or otherwise, this is the place.
Really? Anywhere in particular?
So this place up here on the left? That's one of the main ones. It's run by a Vietnamese woman.
Of course, you probably got the same thing back in Soho. You know how it works.
Yeah, right, yeah. Oh, by the way, either of you two know a copper by the name of Bill Mayo?
Bill Mayo?
Yeah, we were at Hendon together. It must be 20 years ago.
Yeah, he's still around. If you know where to look.
Mayo was one of the detectives forced out after the last Royal Commission on police corruption. He's still persona non grata.
For anything in particular?
How many carats in total?
82. Mainly 2 and 3 carat stones. All round cut like those.
You say you acquired them in the UK?
Mm-hmm. I had to leave in a bit of a hurry.
Why not take them to a registered jeweller?
Well, to be honest, I don't want the attention.
Really, Mr. Murdoch? Strikes me you'd be someone who thrived on it.
Depends on who's doing the attending.
I might know somebody who'd be interested.
That's good.
If you don't mind waiting.
No. I'm in your hands.
A chance bringing all those stones with you?
Not where I had them hidden. I used to be a police officer, most of the time anyway. Then things got a bit complicated, and now I can't go back. Oh, I forgot.
What's that?
That's for Roy and Wayne. Look, I might have other work for them if you think they're reliable.
Depends what you're into.
Well, let's just say I'm looking for opportunities. High risk, high yield.
What? Even with all the cash you got in my safe?
Well, that's not going to last long, is it? Not with the lifestyle I've got in mind. I'm moving into imports.
If that means what I think, you'd better watch your back. Market here's already sewn up.
Yeah, I thought that'd be the case. That's why I'm looking for a partner. Someone with networks, infrastructure, you know?
That's a lot of information for one drink.
That's what poker's all about, Frankie. Reading people fast, backing your judgment, you know?
If that's all you want, I could probably hook you up tonight. For a price.
Yeah.
The guy who owns this club's called Joey Tran.
The thing is, if you did that, then I'd just be another guy with an empty suitcase, wouldn't I? Now, first, I've got to set up some scores, create a reputation. And to do that, I need someone on my side who hears things, is reliable, can put a job together and get rid of the gear, like that.
Sorry, I already have a job.
Oh, really?
Anyway, what makes you think I'd drop everything to play your little game?
I don't know. Maybe I just think that you're smart enough to recognize a winner. You see, I think that you've got ambitions too, Frankie. Something a bit better than this place.
Don't worry about me. This is just temporary.
Since when?
What is it?
I was thinking I must have played this scene out 1,000 times. First time without a warrant card, though.
You can still call it off.
This is the gig. Let's go.
This woman, he says, is it, so what would you prefer, gold, silver, or bronze? So she looks at him and she thinks, I'll tell you what, I'll take silver this time. It's about time he comes second.
Sorry. Who's for another?
No. I insist it's on the Don.
Beauty.
Same again?
Yeah.
Who's winner?
Jimmy Corrigan. Local standover man. Likes his cut of anything going. Looks like we're it.
Send again? Another round of drinks over here, please, love. Oh, and, for yourself.
Very generous. All you can afford to eat from what I eat. Jimmy Corrigan. You're Don Murdoch, right? Are you done a rob?
I think someone's been pulling your leg, Jim.
Never mind, I'll take a drink, you know.
Yeah, all right. So what are you going to have?
Let's see, shall we say $5,000 for raping us? See where we go from there?
I'm sorry, Jim. Even I can't afford to be that generous.
If I put my gun in your mouth? You think that might help?
I tell you what, Jim. Why don't you come and sit down? I might have a much better deal for you.
Okay. Well, we should buy.
The next time we meet, Jim, I want you to show me some respect, got it?
What do you think?
You look fantastic.
What is it you're looking for, Don? I mean, really.
There used to be this guy that I knew in London. His name was Fallon. Had this great big boat, all white and chrome. He used to throw champagne parties on it and cruise up and down the River Thames just so people could stare at him.
What was he, a millionaire?
Well, he wasn't a police officer, that's for sure, picking up garbage for a few lousy grand a year. Yeah, he had respect. He was his own man. I really liked him.
Is that what you're looking for? Respect?
You know, I tried for years to play it straight as a police officer. Now all I want is everything that Fallon had. I think it's time I met Joey Tran.
Frankie says you're looking to do business. What kind of business?
Colombian coke. Container loads if you can handle it. Guaranteed undetectable.
We've been hearing about your successes, Don. But that's still a big jump from doing armed robbery. Sure you can handle it?
Don't worry. I'm wired for it. Caracas via southern Spain. All it needs is a couple of emails and we're in business. That's if you are interested.
Frankie tells me he used to be a cop in London.
Well, that's one story going around. Problem?
Not when you pay the cops as much money as I have. Incidentally. She's not a bad route, is she?
Call name.
Dalroy! You were saying.
Look, I know that heroin is a really big earner for you. I'm offering you a chance to diversify it, spread the risk a bit.
How much coke did you have in mind?
100 kilos a hit. 10% up front, the rest in 30 days. We share the profits 50-50, you and me. You handle distribution and protection.
Well, I need to see a sample first.
No problem. I didn't realize you and Tran have been so close.
Everyone's allowed one mistake.
Yeah.
D.I. Stanton?
Yeah.
Welcome to Sydney.
Hi. D.I. Keane?
No. I'm Detective Senior Constable McAvoy from King's Cross.
From King's Cross? What happened to D.I. Keane?
Look, change of plan while you're in the air. Crime agencies are flat out, so they pass it down the local station.
They passed it down? Do you know why?
Well, as far as they're aware, your man's committed no crimes here and... Well, look, Commander Warren may be able to explain it to you better.
Right, I see.
So how was your flight?
Long. Cheers.
Pick you up around 2 in the afternoon.
2?
Give you a chance to sleep off your jet lag.
Oh, well, I prefer an early start, actually. Say, 9.
see you any time, so if there's anything you need to do, shopping, just have a look around, just say the word.
Thanks, but I need to do a job.
What?
For some time, I believe.
That's right, sir. Various corrupt activities, but mainly in connection with the death of a police officer, a colleague of mine. 2 weeks ago, my boss was contacted by D.I. Keane of crime agencies, and he spoke of an informant claiming to be an ex-London copper seen in company with other criminal targets in the King's Cross area.
We saw the print they pulled off the street cameras. Not exactly conclusive, is it?
Oh, it's him all right, sir. I put my life on it. Now, I'd like to start by recirculating this photo to the other stations, and I'd like to speak to the informant ASAP.
That's Sammy the Turk.
Is he reliable?
Depends when he last had the spike in his arm.
Now, clearly, you're going to have to find your man before you can ID him. But if you do that, we'll be happy to help with the extradition any way we can.
Thank you very much, sir.
Got anything else to go on?
Just the fact that this guy likes to be called the Don, that also fits our man.
It's not much of a lead. Bring someone halfway around the world.
No, but it tells you how much we want him, doesn't it?
The thing I don't understand is if you knew this guy Beach was such a rat bag, how come you let him get away?
I told you he was very resourceful.
Mm-hmm. Is that all you're going to say?
Like most things, it was political. Beach cut a deal with my boss, offering us other corrupt officers in return. And the boss was so desperate to justify his stupid budget, we let him run on a tight rein. Surprise, surprise, he disappears. I told him up front it was a terrible idea.
Where have I heard that before?
Caracas in 6 weeks. They want me and Tron to fly out there next month to inspect and pay a down payment.
By the way, that ex-cop you mentioned, Bill Mayle?
Yeah.
I found him.
Hey, good girl.
Hello, Bill.
Hey there, John.
Hey.
I was wondering when you're going to turn up.
You knew I was here?
Yeah, I knew someone was here. After the headlines you made back home, it wasn't much of a list. 22 years, mate.
Yeah. It's been a long time.
Yeah.
You're looking well. Yeah. Especially for someone who's just recently lost a career.
Yeah.
Detective Sergeant, wasn't it?
Bloody Royal Commission. We had it running sweet, mate.
So I heard. So what are you up to these days? Still keeping you handy?
You know how it is. Bit of business here and there.
Yeah, that's just what I thought.
Yeah, what kind of favour?
Well, it's more of a business reference, really, for someone I'm thinking of working with.
You mean Joey Tran?
This town's smaller than I thought.
Look, take my advice, steer clear.
Why, what's the problem?
Well, Tran's got involved with some heavy drug people. Boundary dispute or something. Word is he's soon for the chop, mate. You get mixed up in that? When he goes, he can take you with him.
You know me, Bill, I'll fight my corner.
Not with these blokes. Trust me. Mate, I'm only telling you for your own good.
Well, what about these other guys, the heavy mob? Do you think they might be interested in some Colombian business?
I don't know, mate. I mean, like I said, they're bad boys. And I'd hate to see you come unstuck.
You let me worry about that, yeah?
See what I can do.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Now remember, you have no authority here, so you just leave this to me, all right?
How are they running for you, Sammy?
Who wants to know?
Detective Senior Constable McAvoy. I need to ask you a few questions about this bloke you propped up, hmm? A bloke called Murdoch?
Sorry, I'm busy at the minute.
Ah, that's all right. We can talk while you watch.
Look, I don't just spill to anyone, D.I. Buxton knows that.
Sammy, you just tell us what you know and we'll be out of here.
Mr. Pommy Tart.
That is no way to talk to a lady, is it? You're a police officer.
So, Sammy, you want to talk now, or should we come back when your mates are here? You want to talk now, don't you?
What I heard, this guy Murdoch arrived 7, maybe 8 months ago. He sold some diamonds, bought some guns, started robbing anything that moved. He's tough, too. Took an iron bar to Jimmy Corrigan, put him in St. Vincent's.
Is that him?
Yeah, I suppose it could be. Looks like him.
Looks like. I don't know. He looks like. Is it or isn't it, Sammy?
I don't know. I've never seen him up close.
Where are we going to find him?
Piermont. He's shacked up with a Vietnamese woman, Frankie Nguyen.
Address?
One of those new apartments overlooking the water. That's all I know. Swear to God.
Thank you very much, Sammy.
I think Sammy's pulling out proverbial, is that it?
Info on the Vietnamese woman was pretty specific.
Sir, she is our only lead, and if she and Beach are together, then it is crucial that we find her. We've got to put in surveillance.
Okay, Claire, we can do that.
Thank you, sir.
And since you're so confident, you can copy an armed hold up as well.
Sorry, sir?
The outstanding robberies that Sammy mentioned. Now they're bound to have pictures on file.
But I thought we agreed that that could just be malicious, you know, someone sticking the knife in.
Better safe than sorry, Claire.
What's wrong?
Did you have to mention the robberies?
What do you mean? Why shouldn't I?
Well, I get it. You're afraid if Beach has done these robs that our blokes will want him first, huh?
Decide to block his extradition. That's it, isn't it?
From now on, you refer everything through me. Is that understood?
I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Now, get this straight. This is still my case, and I have come too far to see it hijacked all over again.
Get off your high horse, Claire. You're not the only cop trying to do a job round here.
What did you say to me?
You heard me. Ever since you got off the plane, you've been playing the hard ass. Like you don't need anyone.
Now you're asking me to cover for you. And lie. I forget it. I'll ask to be reassigned.
Wait. Look, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Can you start again? You see, I didn't realize till it was too late that I was in love with him. You know, the thing that really hurts, I could have told him about Beach, I could have warned him.
He'd still be alive.
Why didn't you?
Truth is, I was afraid.
Afraid?
What he might think. I was an undercover CIB officer, for God's sake. What would you think if I jumped into your bed?
Look, Claire, I know how you must feel. You've got to put it aside. Just do your job.
He has already escaped twice. Now, if I don't get him this time, I don't know what I'm going to do.
If he's here, we'll find him.
Yeah, still won't bring John back though, will it? Change the fact I didn't warn him.
You're a bit hard on yourself, Claire. You are. The way I see it, you had no choice.
Now, we've always got choices, Ken. And it's making the tough ones that tell us who we are.
Always wanted one just like that.
Out of the girl.
Let's face it, Bill. If you got one, you can always get the other. So what's the score?
Looks like we're on.
What, he went for it?
Yeah. Tomorrow morning, 10 a.m, fish market. I'll be waiting at the loading bay.
What's that? Power breakfast or early lunch?
Hello. Brilliant, is she there now? How soon can you pick me up?
Latest update, our suspect's on the move.
Vietnamese woman?
Beach. We've got surveillance following.
That's him. That's Beach.
Oh, wait. That's Bill Mayle. Ex-detective, one of the barbecue set I told you about.
So what?
So we can't just go barging in there, not till we see what's going on.
Well, we're really going to see a lot here, aren't we?
Claire!
Comes here for the oysters. That's his boat over there. One of them.
You know, I should thank you properly for this, Bill.
Oh, don't worry. If this works out, we'll all make a bit.
Yeah.
Recognize anyone?
The bloke on the left, Keith Drury, major organized crime figure. Armed robbery, standover, SP betting, you name it, he's done it. These days it's heroin.
And the other one?
Alex Palmer, Drury's muscle, he's probably armed.
I got it.
You can bet they're not here for the seafood. Wait here.
Where are you going?
Just gonna see who else is around. I don't like surprises.
You just don't blow it.
Hey. Just like being back down Billingsgate.
Yeah, apart from the sunshine, eh?
I think I'm getting used to that. So, what do you reckon? Could you be up for this?
Yeah, seems like a good idea, you know, take a share in each other's business. Spreads the risk.
The Burmese heroin route was knocked sideways last year. East Timor, Solomon Islands, even Fiji. I mean, nothing's safe anymore.
Yeah, well, that was going to be my next point.
I do have one small problem, though.
What's that?
The yellow peril. See, Bill tells me that you're real good mates with a mongrel called Joey Tran.
Hardly mates, Keith. Business partner, that's all. I needed one. It's over now.
Glad to hear it.
Hi, Alex. Yeah. You know, it's a crying shame what's happening to this country. Tragedy. Oh, incidentally, are you still banging that other rice eater? What's her name?
Frankie Nguyen.
Frankie Nguyen. Are you still banging her?
We're still together, if that's what you mean.
I'd be careful there if I was you. Personally, I wouldn't trust anybody that you could blindfold with dental floss.
Yeah, well, I'll choose my own team, if that's all right with you, Keith.
Yeah, well, the choice is yours. But if that's the case, then I'll need something else. You know, just to show me what side you're batting for.
You name it.
Joey Tran's got a casino at Cabramatta. I'd like you to stand over it.
You gotta be joking. Why don't you just tell him to commit suicide?
You coming to the party or what, Don?
You better give me the address.
Have some fish.
Inside. I'll call for backup.
Oh, shit, we're gonna lose him!
Claire, wait!
Tell them to cover the exit!
Wait! Because if he recognised you, we won't see him now for dust. Hey.
He has made a run. There's not much we can do. Too many ways out of the country. Still, you better alert immigration.
It's already done, sir.
Don't understand us. How did you miss him?
Yeah, that's probably my fault, sir. I left Claire without a radio.
Well, that's unfortunate. As for surveillance, I wouldn't bank on him turning up at Piermont. Not as smart as you say.
Sir, I think we should try something else.
Such as?
I think we should transfer surveillance onto Bill Mayle. Let him take us to Beach.
It's not that simple.
Why not?
You've got company, Claire. Federal police want to see you. I'll let them explain. Claire Cairn, this is Agent Vinton, Agent Costas.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Hi. Seat, please.
Hi.
Okay, we're after an information you can give us concerning Don Beach, a.k.a. Don Murdoch.
In connection to what, specifically?
We're running an operation against Keith Drury, Claire. Drug importation.
Yeah, our people were at the fish markets today when he met up with your man, Beach.
And since that makes Beach our target, we thought we should compare notes.
Well, I'm not sure I can help. You see, I'm here to extradite Beach on a murder charge.
Yeah, so we understand. However, it would help us if we could know a little bit more about him.
For instance, has he been involved with drugs before?
Not that I'm aware.
So he wouldn't be linked to any drug importation back in the UK?
Like I said, not that I'm aware.
Okay.
Bloody things. How's their form? Now on, we need to know everything you know.
I don't care if they do have precedence. I am not giving him up. We have just got to find him before they do.
Yeah, but how? Now that put Mail and Jury off limits.
I don't know. Come on. Think. There has to be something. What other connections are there?
Wait a minute.
What?
Do you remember what Sammy said about how Beach took an iron bar to Jimmy Corrigan?
Well, you think you might like to get even?
That's worth a try.
Mate, we've had a request from armed holdup.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it seems they've been running old robbery footage and they need a photo of this guy Beach for their comparisons.
Yeah, sure. There you go, mate. Fax that. Probably not. But I'll cross that bridge when I get to it.
Thanks.
Why don't we leave it for today, eh? You go and get some rest.
No, I'm fine.
Come on, Claire. No need to burn yourself out. We can pick it up tomorrow.
All right. I could do with an early night. You drop me the hotel? Hello.
Hello, Claire. Hey, you're a very long way from home, aren't you? Not to mention well out your depth.
How'd you get this number?
Just simple police work, Claire. Oh, by the way, that's really nice underwear you're wearing.
Where are you? What do you want?
A word from a friend, Claire. Go home while you can, yeah? Because you don't know this place like I do. And I've got a long reach.
I am going to get you, Don. And I'm going to take you back and see you suffer. I promise, John.
Why are you bothering, Claire? I mean, apparently you've come out of it very well. Detective Inspector now, isn't it?
You are sick.
Besides, we both know you haven't got any evidence. You and Hodges are just going to end up looking very, very silly again.
Oh, that's where you're wrong, Don. Because we dug up John's body, and guess what? We found you under his fingernails. Oh, that shut you up, didn't it? What's the matter? Cat got your tongue?
No. You're lying, Claire. Because something like that, they'll have found out first time round.
Oh, in that case, you've got nothing to worry about then, have you?
You're forgetting about Fallon's £500,000, aren't you? I mean, how long do you think I'd last on remand when he found out I was back?
I'll take that risk.
Okay. One last word, Claire. Don't get in my way, please. Because you might end up seeing John a lot quicker than you thought.
Yeah.
No, that's brilliant. Yeah, we'll just keep him there. No, I can be there in under an hour. Yep, great.
How you doing?
Fine.
I was thinking maybe we should move you to a different hotel.
It's okay, it's sorted.
The worst part is, now that he knows you're here, he could just up and run.
No, definitely not. Not the way he was talking. No, we've just got to stay focused and keep going.
Well, that's good. Bondi's just saved us some work. They've just arrested Jimmy Corrigan for drunken resisting.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Tran might not have a future.
He may not be the only one after today. It was me who introduced you, remember?
Look, Frankie, I didn't have a choice. What with the coke deal coming off? I couldn't take the risk. I had to look around.
Yes, but Keith Drury is an evil, racist scumbag, Don!
Look, it's just business, all right? End of story. We need his networks. Besides, with Drury on board, Joe Tran wouldn't dream of coming against us.
Don't be too sure. You don't know him like I do.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
What's that supposed to mean?
Look, I don't know. But maybe it's about time you stood up, Miss Carnage, yeah?
You know you're gonna get me killed.
No, Frankie, come on. It'll be fine. I promise. You know we can't do this without you. The front of the building's too well guarded. Look. Are you with me or against me?
Dog, is that it?
Don't muck us about, Jimmy. We know it was you who put Sammy up to it.
Oh, it must have been a hell of a beating you took, eh? I reckon Murdoch still owes you for loss of reputation.
Look, all you have to do is tell us where to find him and you will never have to see him again.
Well, Barlow's other thing.
Yeah, no worries. But first you've got to show some public spirit.
Well, I don't know where he is.
Oh, come on. Jimmy, I'm not hearing this. Don't stuff me.
Wait, let me finish. All I know is he'll be at Cabra Matter today. Guy I know swipes cards for Murdoch Blacks. He says they're going to give Tran a surprise.
What kind of a surprise?
Work it out for yourself.
Dangerous.
Good one, Don.
Let's start with your money, shall we?
Fill the bags!
We had a deal.
That was yesterday, Joey. Message from Keith Drury, all right? Stay in your own backyard from now on. Let's go!
We'll be right back.
problem?
Nothing.
Hey, come on. Trust me, yeah? Today was just a one-off. Promise.
I hope so. For all of us.
Hey, Marky. What's going on?
Well, the neighbour reported gunshots. Mr. Tran reckons it was kids with firecrackers.
What do they do? Rob the casino?
What casino? They say it's a community centre.
Right, I want to talk to him.
Good luck.
So, firecrackers, was it? Mr. Tran, I have come all the way from England to arrest this man.
Yeah, well, that could prove to be difficult. Arresting a dead man.
Now, you listen to me. You help us find him and your troubles are over. You kill him and I swear to you they are only just beginning.
That simple, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Look, maybe yesterday we could have done business. Not after this.
It's not looking good, is it?
So, we raise our game, we go to the next option.
Claire, we don't have a next option.
Yeah, we do. Bill Mayle.
You heard the feds. Off limits.
I didn't say we're going to talk to him. I said we're going to follow him and see where he leads.
You can dress it up any way you like. It's still asking for trouble.
Only if we get caught. Don't lose him.
Don't panic, Claire. If I get any closer, I'll be up his ass.
Look, he takes the harbour tunnel north, then he turns round and he comes back. I don't think he's a tourist.
Maybe he's just going for a walk.
What the hell?
Well, well, Agents Vinton and Costas.
The two-faced bitch.
Wait, hey!
What the hell did you think you were doing? Freelancing like a couple of kids.
You could have blown the entire operation.
Oh, really? And whose fault is that? You should have told us Bill Mayle was your informant.
We had to protect him.
What, a bent bastard like Mayle? Now, you're an idiot if you think you can trust him.
It was part of the deal when he resigned. No prosecutions in return for information.
Oh, where have I heard that before?
Look, the point is this. Mayle's about to hand us something big, so he can't be approached. Is that understood?
I'm waiting.
There's a freighter coming in with Burmese heroin aboard. 80 kilos in a barrel. They plan to drop it over the side as they come through the heads.
Drury said a few near misses, so somebody else is going to make the pickup and run the drugs ashore by boat.
Mayle told us today that someone is Don Beach.
What?
And when he does, we're going to be the ones there to arrest a lot of them.
So, now you know why you can't go near until it's over.
No, wait a minute. Hang on. What about the murder charge? You telling me you'd rather see Beach set up for some pissy drug importation? What about the extradition?
Sorry, Claire. Just gonna have to get in line.
Hi, lads.
G'day, mate.
Ah, the conquering hero. They told me it caused quite a stir. How did it go, all right?
When? So, we're still in business?
You like the boat?
Yeah, I was thinking of getting one just like it.
Don't bother. It's yours.
What?
You can handle a boat, can't you?
Well enough, yeah.
Come on, let's go and have a look.
It's a pearl.
Call it a present, you know, like a sign of respect.
What's the catch?
No catch, Don.
Come on, Keith.
Well, since we are business partners...
So what do you want me to do?
Well, come on your boat and I'll tell you.
According to intelligence, the ship's due here, around 20:00. One of the crew has a satellite phone on board, so they're obviously going to be in contact with Drury right up until the drugs go over the side. Now, Beach should be somewhere around here, ready to make the pickup and take the packages to Drury. Now, they've got a fast boat, so remember, you need to stay close in case they try to dump the stuff overboard before we make the arrests. Any questions? Good.
Don't worry, Claire. After he's under arrest, you can interview him about anything you like.
Oh, thank you.
Hello?
Frankie, sit down, have a coffee.
No, I can't.
What's the problem?
Joey's been kicking indoors, looking for us, making threats.
Let him come.
Easy for you to say.
Frankie, don't worry. I've got it all sorted. I've got us a boat. This time tomorrow, we'll be heading north. We'll explore the coast. Take a month off. Let everything cool down, yeah?
Are you serious?
Yeah. It's moored at the wharf now. What are you doing tonight? Why don't you come with me, see the fun? You can pour the drinks. I'll do the steering.
No, my sister called. Some problem with the baby. I have to go.
No problem. But be careful, yeah?
I'd like to check some flight details, please. Yeah, I'll hold.
Frankie, what's the problem?
Nothing. It was a false alarm. She's fine. Listen, is it too late to change my mind about coming with you?
Are you kidding? I'll be waiting for you at the wharf. Kick off 7:30, all right? Don't be late.
Gwen, thou beat me out, thou.
Yeah, the party's on, mate. Ship's about 30 minutes off the heads. You can get going then, all right?
Got it.
To Don, urgent.
Don who?
Look, Frankie, just listen to me. Tonight, Don is going to make a pickup. Drugs for Keith Drury. Now, if he does, he's going to be arrested by federal police. You have to warn him.
How do you know about this?
I'm a police officer.
You're the one who's been chasing him?
Look, we haven't got time for this. Frankie, please, do you want to help him or not?
It's probably too late.
What do you mean?
Yep. It's over there.
Yep, that's her.
You know, if this goes wrong, we're both of the sharks. Hello, Donnie. Why don't you come and join me?
He's heading for the drop.
Yeah, well, where the hell's Don?
Turn it off. Put it on the table.
Phone's been switched off.
What's going on? You said he was reliable.
Well, I don't know. Maybe there's trouble with the boat. But we can't ignore the drop. That's $2 million out there.
All right, we'll do it. But remember, if anything goes wrong, it's down to you.
Sure.
Joey, this wasn't personal, you know. Just good business, that's all.
Yeah. My sentiments exactly.
How did you find me? Was it Frankie?
Bloody hell, Drury's going for it himself.
I'll tell him to stand by.
No sense in waiting now.
Take him.
Come on, Don. Aren't you going to beg for your life?
I would, if I thought it'd do any good.
Stay here and keep your mouth shut.
Hey, Joey.
Stay behind me.
Claire, you see, this boat's everything I've ever worked for. And I've got enough juice on board to get me to places that you can't follow, so take one last look. You won't be seeing me again.
Don't you try it, Don!
You won't fire, Claire. You're a police officer, remember?
I'm warning you! Not one more step!
See? What did I tell you?
D.I. Stanton?
Yes?
I think you'd better come along with us.
Why?
We found Beecher's boat.
We found his personal effects. British passport, name of Murdoch.
And the body?
Probably shark bait by now. Forensics found a lot of blood on the deck.
Way things were found. Seems Tran tried to settle a score and got hit. How many others were involved, we'll probably never know.
I don't suppose you've got any ideas, Claire.
The feds told us to stay well away. Remember, sir?
So?
Well, I guess this is it. Back to 9 degrees centigrade and pissing rain.
How's the...
Oh, yeah. No worries. The skull must be thicker than I thought.
Lucky for both of us. Thanks, Ken.
For what? Doing my job?
Thank you for just being brilliant.
So what'll you do now?
I don't know. I've got a lot to think about. Bye.
Goodbye, Claire. I'm sorry you didn't get your man.
Something I have to live with.